दर्पण को, दिल के दर्पण को सफा कर, दूर कर अभिमान को, खाक हो गुरु के कदम की, तो प्रभु मिल जाएगा तुझी परम
जिन्होंने अपनी उम्र के मुताबिक संगीत से अभी तक जितना सीखा व समझा था, वो संगीत की जिस गहराई तक ले जाने का प्रयास किया है, वे हमारे लिए अवश्य ही लाभकारी होगा। मैं स्पीक में के ग्रुप का भी धन्यवाद करना चाहूँगी, जिसके कारण ही आज हमें यह सौभाग्य प्राप्त हुआ।
बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि नहीं तो सब कॉलेज में यूनिवर्सिटी में सब डिस्को डांस करते रहेंगे। हमारा जो कल्चर है वो बचाने में, उसका प्रचार करने में बहुत अच्छा काम करते हैं। जब हर एक को बुलाते हैं, सुनाते हैं, प्रचार करते हैं यूनिवर्सिटी में कॉलेज में, सब वहाँ के स्टूडेंट्स को बहुत अच्छी यानी आदत हो जाती है कि हमारा कल्चर कितना बड़ा है।
जो शास्त्रीय संगीत है वो बड़ों तक ही सीमित रखा जाता है। अब हम जैसे हैं तो हम में से कई लोग हैं कि जिनको अच्छा नहीं लगता, लेकिन अगर इस तरह की चीज़ें और रखी जाएंगी तो हो सकता है हम में थोड़ी नई उसको सीखने की थोड़ी प्रेरणा जागे और हम ज़्यादा सीख सकें उससे।
बट थिंग्स दैट अपलिफ्ट, थिंग्स दैट रियली मूव ह्यूमन बींग्स, वेरी यंग फ्यू यंग पीपल आर गोइंग टूवर्ड्स दैट, एंड वी हैव टू रिजुविनेट द सोसाइटी, वी हैव टू मेक यंग पीपल थिंक अबाउट दीज थिंग्स and make them come towards such, at least let them experience some of these very deep moments which many aspects of our heritage can provide.
Overwhelmed by the potency of classical Indian art forms and confronting their own feelings of vacuity, four young students in 1978 gave birth to a movement, Spik McKay. Today it is a dynamic and vital part of more than 400 schools and colleges all over India.
It's only unintentionally that these things can happen. Nobody intends it.
It encourages the young to participate actively and voluntarily in organizing a series of events that range from lecture demonstrations to concerts by eminent artists and performers, who in turn give of their time voluntarily.
I think their role is very critical, because how many schools, even if they believed in this sort of literacy, would have the sort of resources that Spik McKay has been able to muster. Children see these people in flesh and blood. They literally, they can talk to them, interact with them, ask them questions. This can be a tremendous source of inspiration on the one hand. On the other hand, the reality of their existence and of lifetime of work, sometimes generations of work, which they would never get through other experiences.
Spik McKay has evoked the unstinting support and encouragement of India's leading classical performers. It provides an opportunity for rare and unique interactions. The movement fosters a sense of community, of the willingness to be responsible, to serve. It seeks to promote culture not as a passive taking in, but a living, vibrant experience.
जरा खींच के चलो, जरा खींच के, हाँ ये ठीक है, इसको दिमाग हल करता है, समझता है, दिल फैसला करता है। ये सीख मैके बहुत उम्दा चीज़ है, बड़ी उम्दा चीज़ है, और उनके संबंध जो हैं जिसके कार्यकर्ता लोग हैं इनसे हम बहुत करीब हो गए, पैसा इतना नहीं है, लेकिन ये प्रोग्राम ऐसा करते हैं कि तमाम बच्चों को सुनवा रहे हैं, किसी का भी प्रोग्राम हो उसको सुनो तो कलाकार जो होगा उसका मूड बनेगा, उसका दिल खुश होगा कि बच्चे बड़े अच्छे हैं, और अगर उसमें होर्डिंग करना शुरू करो तो कहेगा कि भाई हम कहाँ पहुँच गए।
Whose art can evoke the sublime, ineffably transforming emotions in their audiences, give so generously of themselves to Spick McKay as the ultimate validation of their commitment.
Others. It's not just listening to classical music. That can be done through cassettes or whatever you get. But when you work as a team, right, it gives you a sense of, like, it brings you closer than many other aspects of it. I have learned organization, I have learned discipline, I have been exposed a lot. I can handle things, it's given me confidence.
Young people find themselves doing unusual things as they participate in a process that sensitizes them to the broader aspects of culture. The end is not just a distant goal. Its essence lies all along the way, linked closely with the means. The miracle of Spick McKay is that it functions through an elaborate national network of volunteers. Young people, while in school and college, who pledged their time. A small, relatively stable core group based in Delhi provides direction and continuity. Spick McKay's success demonstrates that large numbers of young people can inspire each other into assuming responsibility.
थोड़ा सा just ले लो.
Okay.
Yeah. No.
Okay. एक कौन आएगा? थोड़ी थोड़ी नहीं. और करो और जाएगा पीछे. ये बीच में आएगा नहीं.
The movement itself is as much the message as are the repositories of India's classical heritage that it promotes. And the organization of programs is a process in itself of learning, of imbibing, and most importantly, of being inspired.
Spick McKay is not trying to promote Indian classical music and dance. That's not the main aim of Spick McKay. It's using it as a medium. It's one of the most powerful horses we have, and we are using it as a medium to get to this experience, this very deep, abstract, subtle, inspiring experience. Look at the sky, you see it's blue and there are some clouds and there are some birds flying around and you feel happy. But today we just have forgotten to feel passionately about anything at all. But I think Spick McKay is the one that's been giving me a lot of nourishment. I think, yeah, that's the word I've been looking for, yeah. It's been nourishing me very holistically, time and again. It's just a way of life. It's a way of looking at everything. It's a way of, it's a way how you greet a person when he comes to your house for the first time. I mean, it's as basic as that. So that is what we really confronted for the first time in our lives.
कि मैं शुरू ही से स्पीक मेकर के साथ हूँ, उसका एक मेंबर हूँ, तो छोटी छोटी जगहों में जाकर ख़ास तौर से स्टूडेंट्स को, तालिब इल्मों को, विद्यार्थियों को, जो है हमने अपनी सभ्यता, अपनी तहजीब और अपना तमद्दुन सिखाया और बताया और समझाने की कोशिश की है और आज तक कर रहे हैं. हमारी तहजीब और हमारा धार्मिक जो एक रिश्ता और एक संबंध है वो असल में शास्त्रीय गायन से है, वो शास्त्रीय उसूलों और प्रिंसिपल्स से है. भगवान राम कहते हैं कि मैं कहीं नहीं मिलता, ना ऋषियों से मिलता, ना मुनियों में मिलता, ना जो भजन करते हैं उनमें मिलता, बल्कि मैं मिलता वहाँ हूँ. मैं आपको रामायण सुना रहा हूँ. मिलता मैं वहाँ हूँ जहाँ गायन होता हूँ. तो जब ये हमारी सभ्यता है तो शास्त्रीय संगीत एक ब्रिज है उस बालिक तक पहुँचने के लिए. आज अगर हम इन शांत रूप से उस मालिक को पहचानें, उसको समझें, उसकी पूजन करें, उसको याद करें, दिल में श्रद्धा रखें, तो आज जितने झगड़े हैं, जितने टंटे हैं, जितने फसाद हैं, जितने भी हमारे आपके यानी कि जो है वो यानी ये दूरियां हैं जो एक बड़ा अफसोसनाक और बहुत ही आजकल एक सबसे ज़्यादा यानी कि जो है इस बात के कहने की ज़रूरत है कि ये जितने भी यानी कि जो है वो शासन के लिए, कुर्सियों के लिए, ताकत के लिए, हुकूमत के लिए जितने भी झगड़े और फसाद हो रहे हैं, तो अगर ये संगीत को समझें, अगर ये शास्त्रों को समझें, अगर ये धर्म को समझें, तो आज ये तमाम झगड़े और तमाम फसाद पीस में बदल जाएंगे और इन नफ़रतों को बदल दिया जाएगा.
और शुरू शुरू में वो कॉलेज में, हाई स्कूल में करते थे, एक तीन चार वर्ष के पीछे छोटे छोटे बच्चे स्कूल में हुआ मेरा प्रोग्राम. उस वक्त उन लड़के को ज़बरदस्ती बिठा दिए थे उधर. एक लड़का कान में हाथ डाल दिया, हम गाने शुरू किए. वो टीचर वगैरह यही करने से फिर ऐसा बैठता था, फिर ऐसा करता था डर के मारे में. आजकल वो बैठते हैं, हम बोलते हैं कभी कभी किसी को जाना हो तो जाइए, नहीं जाते. इसलिए मुझे आज अच्छा लगता है, बहुत बाहर प्रोग्राम होते भी स्पीक मेक में हम आते हैं, मुझे अच्छा लगता है.
Problem is one of getting the young person to have a little patience and a little faith. These two things. And you know, Star TV, MTV, all these things are, all the outside influences which are coming, they have to come. I have never saying that they should stop. But what they are doing is they're reducing the concentration or the span of patience of an individual day by day. You know what I'm saying? That is the thing which I'm very worried about. Truth can be, any human being has the ability to recognize truth, but it must be given, there must be a chance given to truth. I must be ready to say, look, I'm ready to check it out. For the checking out, it can't be the same checking out as you have with that checking out of Michael Jackson. It can't be. The format has to be a little different. That format requires two things: some patience and some faith.
One such format is the Gurukul scheme. The Gurukul scholar embarks on a month-long journey of discovery and self-exploration. Here, Gaurika and Shilpa have chosen to spend their time at a Tibetan nunnery in McLeodganj in Dharamsala.
Gurukul, perhaps, for me it means that because in this nowadays you don't tend to be, you know, really near someone who is supposed to be doing something nice, wonderful about, and is convinced of that what he or she is doing. Like, I'm not expected to learn about Buddhism in 1 month, which is impossible anyway. People take years and years to learn.
I think it makes you reflect on the way we live, you know. I mean, their unquestioning faith in certain in a way of life in some people, say for example His Holiness, and the fact that they can actually take in strangers without any qualms. I think it makes us reflect on the way we live and our attitudes and our activities as well, because they live in austerity, and that austerity is not necessarily imposed from the outside.
The girls interact intimately with the nuns and participate in the many aspects of community life in the nunnery. The catalysts for holistic development can come from varied quarters, and the life of a nun indeed can provide valuable insights to a spiritual way of life, where the emphasis lies in cultivating altruism, concentrating not on what you can take, but what you can give. The experience epitomizes Spikmike's aims: to realize the importance of a cultural tradition and its role in the life of a people.
If they went from our nunnery, we all very feeling sad, because now we are very close each other, and nuns are very loved to these two girls, and they very like to us. So we are sometimes cooking together, prayer together when they are stay here. So we are talking about our tradition, so their mind must change.
Say if I'm very angry about something,
yeah,
and I think it out in my mind and then work it out differently.
The essence of the Gurukul scheme is to provide a brief experience of the Guru Shishya Parampara.
You know, thinking about how to resolve the problem in a different way, you have been practicing patience. So that, in fact, is a positive activity. So you create virtue.
Spikmike's activities have diversified into the written word. Its publication, The I, aims to provide an intellectual framework for the worldview Spikmike embodies. It is made possible by the same volunteerism that permeates all of Spikmike's initiatives.
It's very much in keeping with the basic logo of Spikmike, which is also the third eye, which is a symbol of knowledge and understanding. And we wanted the magazine to be very closely, since it is a Spikmike publication, to be linked up closely with that. And the eye as itself, by itself, has a significance of being an instrument of perception. The idea behind it is that we'd get a lot of young people involved in two things. One is in contributing for the magazine in terms of articles and stuff. The other is also in the distribution or the dissemination of the magazine itself. Our target is definitely the young adult. The adult who is in college, who is out of college in an active working area. Therefore, we have chosen subjects that have tried to explore culture in its entirety So people were a little surprised that why would a Spikmiki magazine deal with a subject like consumerism or talk about development issues. So they all have a link and a tie-up. So our magazine tries to link up and break down these interdisciplinary walls.
Is the unity of India, is it based on agreement or is it based on difference? I think these are the two views about the unity of India. Instead of putting your faith in the government, you put your faith in society.
The school group is another of Spikmikay's activities aimed at inculcating a sensitivity to the larger aspects of culture. The group attempts to expose young minds to the insights and perspectives on a variety of themes by academics who would not ordinarily interact with the young.
And I said I'll stop there because I hope Spikmikay is also one of these movements and will not rely on government support but will only rely on our social support.
I mean, sure, anybody who comes here, perhaps not today, you're not really impressed. But 5 meetings of Spikmiki and you would have a broader view.
We as members of the Spikmiki, do our work, and the objective of Spikmiki is to spread our culture and culture towards other people. So if we are doing our duty in that, then obviously other people also will be able to know about other cultures.
इसके अलावा ना सितार भारत है, ना सरोद भारत है, ना तबला भारत है, ना गजल भारत है, ना ठुमरी भारत है, कुछ भी नहीं है। अगर भारत है तो वो ये है। तो लिहाजा ये है भारत की पूजा। कुटिगुनम स्तोत्रम स्तोत्रात कुटिगुनम जपय जपात कुटिगुनम गानम। गानात पर धर्म नहीं। हर धर्म के अंदर मोक्ष के लिए कुछ ना कुछ कहा गया है, लिहाजा ये हमारे पूर्वजों ने इसको मोक्ष का रास्ता बनाया है कि संगीत को यानी नाद को जो है हम ब्रह्म रूप मानकर उसकी उपासना करें और अपने ईश्वर को पालें। अब होता है या नहीं होता है बहरहाल, लेकिन दरिया के किनारे पे खड़े होकर कभी गहराई का अंदाज़ा नहीं किया जा सकता जब तक कि उसमें गोता ना लगाया जाए।
Spikmikay's attempts have helped to make the practitioners of the classical art forms models for emulation.
कलाकारों के साथ जो students संपर्क में आते हैं और उनसे उन इस प्रक्रिया में जो उनके मन मस्तिष्क पर जो प्रभाव गिरता है वो उनके ताज़िंदगी जो उनका जो अपना एक विकास होता है दिमाग का कहेंगे व्यक्तित्व का कहेंगे उस पर भी प्रभाव डालता है और वो निश्चित रूप से अच्छा ही होता है।
सब लोग इसमें मानसिक रूप से कार्य करते हैं तो
कभी कभी कम्युनिकेशन गैप जिसको कहते हैं तो हो जाता है
लेकिन वो तो उसमें इनबिल्ट है स्पीक मेकर में उसको आपको मान के चलना पड़ेगा कि गड़बड़ियाँ इसमें होंगी इसलिए अगर वो प्रॉपर इस्टेब्लिशमेंट होगा ऑफिस होगा सब काम करने वाले होंगे तो ये फिर उसी एक आम
संस्था की तरह
परिवर्तित हो जाए लेकिन जो इसका एक खुला स्वरूप है ये बहुत फायदेमंद है और इससे कुछ थोड़े बहुत नुकसान होते भी हैं तो वो तो हर सिस्टम की अपनी कुछ कमी आएंगी।
स्पिकमा की दिस वॉलेंट्री ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज टू is having programs, is moving from year to year into lots of activities and whole of that that gamut of activities have to be coordinated, have to be organized and the organizers are the people who get into Spikmake to say I will like to put in my energies into participating in Spikmake, what they have learnt, what they have enjoyed to share it with others. So for that, they are more hands who get involved in it.
We have been talking a lot about the issues involved in Spikmake from the finance angle, from we'll be talking about the publicity angle.
An annual convention brings together most of the more than 1,500 active volunteers from some 150 chapters from all over India. It is through the efficient functioning of this network that makes it possible to organize more than 1,000 different events each year.
These guys have to be paid.
The overriding concern of the volunteers has become the raising of resources to ensure the continuing vitality of Spikmake. A unique feature of Spikmake is the nature of its funding. It has thus far successfully shunned commercial endorsements, receiving instead the bulk of its support from the government of India, private trusts and foundations. More than 95% of its resources go directly into its programs.
They are only interested in music, that's all. So how are you going to generate your finance?
We can't mix up this.
And you see, it's very difficult.
One way emotion is carried.
And we just have two or three people running around for finance. How much can we cover?
So a lot of our creative activity, which could have been otherwise spent in trying to figure out more ways of increasing the chances of success of the final aim of Spikmake, are going towards things which I think is sad, but it's a fact that we are struggling on the financial front.
Although I'm a businessman, I have practiced music for more than 40 years myself. I see that this is an organization which is doing a yeoman service for the country. They are bringing about a cultural change which I don't think any government can bring about. And as a responsible citizen, I felt that this activity which is being performed and propagated by Spikmake needs support.
Young people who would have had no chance to get attracted to our classical music have already become so much interested in it. And I think that's very important because music is not just for entertainment, but to appreciate, not only just to learn, but to even appreciate it, it has a civilizing effect. I think it is the most important thing. And they are doing such good job, but unfortunately, it's not very easy. And I would sincerely appeal to the business houses and Indian community in general to give as much help to speak Maki.
In 1978, gave birth to a movement, Spik McKay. Today, it is a dynamic and vital part of more than 400 schools and colleges all over India.
It's only unintentionally that these things can be made. Nobody intends it.
It encourages the young to participate actively and voluntarily in organizing a series of events that range from lecture demonstrations to concerts by eminent artists and performers who in turn give of their time voluntarily.
I think their role is very critical. Because how many schools, even if they believed in this sort of literacy, would have the
of resources that Spik McKay has been able to muster. Children see these people in flesh and blood. They literally, they can talk to them, interact with them, ask them questions. This can be a tremendous source of inspiration on the one hand. On the other hand, the reality of their existence and of lifetime of work, sometimes generations of work, which they would never get through other experiences.
Spik McKay has evoked the unstinting support and encouragement of India's leading classical performers. It provides an opportunity for rare and unique interactions. The movement
फर्स्ट हो जाती है कि हमारा कल्चर कितना बड़ा है।
जो शास्त्रीय संगीत है वो बड़ों तक ही सीमित रखा जाता है। अब हम जैसे हैं तो हम में से कई लोग हैं कि जिनको अच्छा नहीं लगता, लेकिन अगर इस तरह की चीज़ें और रखी जाएंगी तो हो सकता है हमें थोड़ी नई उसको सीखने की थोड़ी प्रेरणा जागे और हम ज़्यादा सीख सकें उससे।
बट थिंग्स दैट अपलिफ्ट, थिंग्स दैट रियली मूव ह्यूमन बींग्स, वेरी यंग, फ्यू यंग पीपल आर गोइंग टूवर्ड्स दैट एंड वी हैव टू रिजुविनेट the society. We have to make young people think about these things and make them come towards such, at least let them experience some of these very deep moments which many aspects of our heritage can provide.
Overwhelmed by the potency of classical Indian art forms and confronting their own feelings of vacuity, four young students in
आपने हम बच्चों जिन्होंने अपनी उम्र के मुताबिक संगीत से अभी तक जितना सीखा व समझा था को संगीत की जिस गहराई तक ले जाने का प्रयास किया है वे हमारे लिए अवश्य ही लाभकारी होगा। मैं स्पिक मके ग्रुप का भी धन्यवाद करना चाहूँगी जिसके कारण ही आज हमें यह सौभाग्य प्राप्त हुआ।
बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं क्योंकि नहीं तो सब कॉलेज में यूनिवर्सिटी में सब डिस्को डांस करते रहेंगे। हमारा जो कल्चर है वो बचाने में उसका प्रचार करने में बहुत अच्छा काम करते हैं। जब हर एक को बुलाते हैं, सुनाते हैं, प्रचार करते हैं यूनिवर्सिटी में कॉलेज में, सब वहाँ के स्टूडेंट्स को बहुत अच्छी यानी आदत हो